The market is well off its lows. We were down 250. Now we're down, what, 73 points. That's it. Come on in, Scott Martin, Fox News contributor. Scott, I don't think that all the political drama, the turmoil, the toxic politics, all this about investigations and impeachment, I don't think that has hit the market at all. Am I right?
I think in some cases it's starting to, Stuart. Now, here's your point that I'll agree with. It may not hit the market just right in the face. It may be a glancing blow kind of on the shoulder, because I think there are times the S&P has reacted to the Mueller investigation. There are times that, you know, even over the course of, say, the midterm elections, that the markets did take a breather afterwards because they were worried about this bipartisanship that has been lackluster and materializing. So here's the thing. Right now, though, the market psychology is such, Stuart, where any kind of negative headline, whether it is trade, as you were just talking about with Steve Moore, or even a Fed meeting this week, which is just coming up, any kind of negative headline seems to really hit the market pretty hard because the psychology is so fragile.
But if we get, I mean, let's go with what Steve Moore was saying. Let's suppose we get a trade deal of some sort with China. President Trump really wants it. The Chinese can't really go without a trade deal. What happens to the market if we do indeed get that trade deal?
I think the market rallies, but I believe it's somewhat short term, because as this is drawn out, the market has started again psychologically to find other problems. You know, margin compression in our S&P 500 companies, maybe a slowing economy. I know you guys, you know, pointed out this 3%, you know, GDP rate that we may see for fourth quarter. Well, we wanted, you know, in the fours. And so the market just feels like it's already starting to concentrate on other weaknesses, even if we do get the great news of a China deal. But the point was well taken. It's a good short term deal that we're going through here to play this one for the long term. And that's something, as an S&P 500 investor, as a money manager myself, that's what you have to keep your eye on here, just not so much the next couple months, but the next couple years.
Yeah, for most of our viewers are longer term investors, and I think a lot of them might want to consider taking advantage of this dip. We'll see how it goes. Scott, thank you very much, sir. Good stuff.